What is up, everybody? My name is James Fox, also known as Epic, and welcome to Guild Wars 2. Well, actually, this is not a playthrough. Not yet. Yes, this is going to be a playthrough, and no, I'm not doing it by myself. I'm having help with a friend. My friend, I'm not gonna say her name, because I'm not sure if she wants credit for it yet. Me and her are going to be doing a playthrough together of Guild Wars 2. Now, if you haven't heard of Guild Wars 2 or Guild Wars, where have you been all your life? Like, it's a really fun game, honestly. One problem with it is, there's no elves. I don't see any elves, guys. Do you see elves? No, I don't see elves. It's sad. I love elves. Like, honestly. There's a fucking attempt of an elf pun. So, I don't know if you guys know, but you should go follow me on Instagram. FishermanNinjaFox is the Instagram account, but you guys should follow me, because I have 106 followers now on Instagram. Finally, after so long, it's so impressive, and it makes me so glad that I have 106 followers. You couldn't tell by that, I'm trying to finish following people on Instagram. Before I get started with this, I just want to say, shout out to all people who are following me right now on Instagram, and who are following me on Twitter, as well as all people who are following me on, So, if you haven't heard of Guild Wars 2, it's an MMORPG. Well, I just checked and the stream started today at 10, so I'm gonna have to do that tomorrow. But, let's get into this. I'm not gonna read the descriptions. You can read them or look them up on the website. I just hope to see what I should when I play through it with friends. Only thing is, what we're playing is 2 out of the 5 races. I do want us to play as all 5 races, though. And there'll be a playthrough for each race. So first of all, you have Ashar. My 3 words to describe them: giant horned cat. Humans. Normal humans are. Norn. They're icy hunters. That you could call them giants, but they're really not, because they're a little taller than a human. And a little bit bigger. The Asura. They're Dobbies, basically. Just like picture Dobby, but with power of science. And then the Silvari, humanoid plant people. So let's get into this. I'm actually going to be just humans, but I'm going to show off every class of armor for both the race, the human, and the humanoid. So first off, I'm going to have them for the humanoid. But actually, I can't call them classes. No, they don't have classes in Guild Wars 2. You have professions. Now, it is fully customizable, so, like, if you can do it, yes, you can customize with your character, but the basic classes are these ones. This one is the upcoming class, the Revenant, which means the part of the ones. So, you have the Warriors, they wear heavy armor, Guardians, basically on that Paladin, and they wear heavy armor as well. Rangers, proficient with a bow, and they have a pet that follows them. But you don't know, you can, there are, like, you have to look at the wiki, but there's a list of weapons that, for each class or profession. The thief, we all know what a thief is. Medium armor, did I say what rangers are? Rangers are medium armor. Engineers are medium armor. We can guess what an engineer is. They're a technological and alchemical masterminds. Necromancers. They wear light armor, and we all know the necromancers. I just noticed this. They're all categorized by what armor size they are, or what armor they are. Heavy armor, so I guess the Redmans can be heavy armor. Medium armor, and then light armor. Then you have the Elementalists. They're like the mages of the group, except for they only use the 4 types of magic: water, fire, air, and earth. Then you have the Mesmer. The Mesmers are really fun to play as, honestly. honestly, if you have to pick between two classes, generally if you're going to pick, honestly, pick the Mesmer. The Mesmers are mages, like, all the mages that use them. Now for the female human armor classes. This isn't like the starting armor, this is the final armor. Now we're gonna move on to this one. I closed my eyes when I did that, by the way. Yes, sir, we're gonna start with the female this time. We're gonna start with the warrior. Yesura are really interesting race in the way it's put in aspects. That they're like subterranean little people. That's like how they were described at first. Lord Guardian. And the Ranger. And I should specify whenever plays a ranger. The only pet each class has, like, I mean, each race does have a different pet for the ranger, and that's the only one that's like that for some reason. But there is one pet I have noticed that is in all of the ranger races, and it's the stalker. And it's a cat. Really likes these people. And I won't show you all of their customizations for what their thing is, because they let you actually pick the story of what their character is. I shut the mail, right? No, I don't think I shut the mail. Yeah, I didn't shut the mail, right? Did I? I'm not going to tell you all the story options for the for all the characters, because I'm not going to tell you too much time as it is. You'll see what I mean by cats or cats. But look, like, don't they look like cats, honestly? Like, they look like big cats. I'm really, like, I guess I should explain why there's not a lot of content going out. If you didn't know, I'm back in school. I probably said this like a zillion times, but I'm sure there's a zillion times. I'm back in school, which means I have homework and a bunch of other stuff to do. So recording is not on top of my priority list. The things that are on top of my priority list are sometimes recording with them. Getting my homework done, staying on top of my grades and everything. So you guys can understand why there's a lot of I have to say though, if I was gonna play as a Char, I would probably be a female Char. They look less ferocious. You know, I don't like that one looks ferocious though. Yeah. A cool gear. I think I started with this row. The Norn, and then we'll get the cancel. I'm gonna stop eating. So the Norn armor, I think, is a little bit cool. It's a lot like the humans. Yeah, some of it's a little different, some of it's not. Yeah, like that and the warrior. I think the humans are pretty much easy. They're almost different. This is a little different. That's my system. But what about Phaelos? Hold on. Okay. I'm back. Still the stuff in here. More water. Now you see what I mean by their. Okay, is it me, or does this shoulder look bigger than the other? But like I was saying, the Norn are a lot like giants, like they're big and blue. Like, I think the armors for the two humanoid base races are similar in certain ways, but like not the same as the other humans. Like, yeah, pretty sure that's not what the other ones like. Hold up. If you don't know, I have a bangle I always wear. Does that not look like what my bangle has on me? Because it closely resembles it. Hours customizing. The Silvari. Honestly, like, no joke, for some reason, whenever I play as a Silvari, I can't help but play as a Ranger. Like, the Silvari just scream Ranger. Or Necromancer, I think it's really fun. I think it's really funny when people play as the Necromancer class, like, as a Ranger. It just, it's like, you know, counting through. Hey, you know, all of us should get together sometime, and you know what we should do? We should go on a Silvari. I have a rib shot on the rim, but I have a rib. People should follow me like, whoa, holy crap, people are just following me like crazy. I have 140 followers now. That's shocking. Guardian. The Ranger. I like that hairstyle right there, though. I'll show you what the Engineer. The Necromancer. Whenever I hear like Necromancer, I have the urge to say Necromancer because of World of Warcraft. Alrighty, so now I'm gonna go to the Warrior and I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about by choice. So each class, each race will have a different storyline except the first one. And that is for the Warriors is I wear blank on battlefield because of this I am recognized. You can wear a spangle helm, a Leia, and then don't wear a helmet on your shoulder. And then the question that will always come next is, trouble may follow me, but I use my charm, dignity, or ferocity to overcome it. And all of them look the same for all three, for all five races, and just different questions for the main classes that I was mentioning. Guardian, it's a symbol of my dedication. As a symbol of my dedication, I wear Conqueror's Cauldrons, Fantastic Cauldrons, and Visionary. You have to pick one of them. The Ranger, it's going to be different for... Actually, this is like the only exception of this era. I know you saw the MOA from the Asura, but it's different color. This one's blue colors, maybe, and they're different. Like, there is a huge difference. Like, Stalker is the only one that stays the same for all of the classes. Well, for all of the races, I think. Infernal. Well, the only one that will stay the same is the Stalker. Depending on what race you pick, you'll have two different options. The Thief. I actually played as a thief, an Asuran thief for a while, and I actually thought it was really kind of like, oh yeah, an Asuran thief, that does fit really well. So in my line of work, it is important to understand the power of anonymity, and like, I forget what it's called, but it like covers four ways of life. This is my determination. In the beta, this actually covered your eyes. It was like, if I can't see you, you can't see me. And then Subterfuge, whatever that means. I wish I could have done that. Engineer. For the engineer, like, their options are much better. So, my most powerful tool is my Panoscopic Monocle, a universal multi tool attack, or Eagle Eye Goggles. The Necromancer. Guys, do you even necro? A necromancer's closest companion is death. I acknowledge my, in acknowledgement of this, I mark my face with the symbol of a trickster demon. I don't know. The skull, wall skull, or ghostly wraith. I like the ghostly wraith. Elementalist, and you'll see what I mean now. I study all the elements, but I wear the gem that symbolizes my love for water, and this is the fire, earth, and air. Now, no warning, choose wisely for this, because when you first start out, you don't have access to any of the other three elements that you pick that are listed. You only have option to the one you pick until later. I think it's in the skill tree. And then the Mesmer is probably the coolest. They have masks. A Mesmer's mask creates an image I should know how it can be. Harlequin smile. Phantasm of Sorrow, or Fang of Death. And this one reminds me of, what is it called? I think I made it. Yep, I think I made it. Oh, gosh. Japanese Fang Yokai Mask. It's either Tegu or Oni. It's one of the two. I'm looking at Tegu because I always go to Tegu guys. Okay, no, it's not Tegu. It does not have a giant network. Yes, it is the Oni. It is, like, it reminds me of the mask of an Oni. Actually, no, it's an Oni. Yeah, it's an Oni, but it also kind of resembles a Hanaya. Yeah, I can't pronounce that. Don't think. But, like, for the different races, it'll ask you the other. Alright. So, after the first 7 questions, it'll ask you. Will ask you 3 races to go to. Yeah, it'll ask you 3 races and questions. So know that, so like for the Aserta, or like for the Savari, or Savari, it'll ask you like what your vision is. And then what time you woke. Just gonna go with like the generic ranger. Show off these. For the Asura, it will ask you like I'm a member of the College of Statics, Dynamics, and Synergetics. It'll ask you what your first invention was. It'll ask you who your mentor is. And then for the Nord, why do I keep on saying Nord? I need to ignore it. Norns have like the coolest set. Oh wait, no, the Norns don't have a stalker, they have the snow leopard. They have like, you can choose a bear, a wolf, if I chose a wolf, and some innocent leopard. But that's just to replace the stalker because of what? Then you're like asked, most important quality I have is that is the necessary. I add a recent and then when I was still a kid, I had a vision of the Spirit of the Wild to, Spirit of the Wild spoke to me and offered its guardianship. That spirit was there, wolf. Alright, now, after I finish the sentence, I want you to pause the video and put in the comments which spirit animal you think I would pick or I would have done, like if we do in the right let's play. So stop the video right here, and then post your comment. Alright. Now, if you chose Raven, you're correct. Shockingly enough, you can't actually get away with it. The humans, like, human backstory is a little bit messy, right? Pet bear. That's just a... Oh, look at that. You know what? We got another. We now have 117, but you know what? I would never choose a bear to be my first pet in Guild Wars 2 because it would be unbearable. Thank you, everybody. I'll be here all night. Then, like, the 3 questions are really, really sad. I was raised by the Ancients, Common Folk. One of my biggest regrets is I've never searched for my own companions, and it was my sister's body, and then the last one was her voice that I was rescuing by looking at Luna, Brent, Balthazar, Nalura, Lycia. Then the last race we're going to look at for their factories is the char. I kind of like one of the char's pets, and that's the Devourer. It just, like, it looks really nice. Now, I am proud to be Ash Legion, a Blood Legion soldier, or an Iron Legion soldier. I would die for my warband, especially Maverick, Erling, Phosphor, Indy, and Eva, my Spartan. They tell me the soldier that strike me is the soldier. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this little introduction to World War II. I'm actually looking forward to keep learning with my friend. Hopefully we'll see you guys next time. As always, go ahead and like, share, and comment. Go follow me on Twitter at MiniageBox. Go follow me on Instagram at OfficialMiniageBox. And go to my spreadsheet page. All the way on my channel if you want to go find them. Just click to the channel homepage. Right hand corner, of the channel itself, you will see three little things. Have a great day. Bye.